Hello, everyone. Welcome to IEEE Green Tech 2021. And welcome to our tutorial, Introduction to Digital Control for Power Electronics. Your instructors are Professor Marcelo Simons, very truly yours, and Professor Thiago Bussarello, who you meet very soon. We have four modules. I teach modules 1 and 3, while Professor Bussarello teaches modules 2 and 4. We are alternating. There are 4 videos. Every time we end a video, we'll have a session of discussion and questions and answers on that module. Each part lasts from 20 to 25 minutes. We have a total of 2 hours for this course. We both hope that you enjoy. We put a lot of time and efforts to make this 2 hours tutorial enjoyable and useful. And now we begin.
We analyze traditional power systems as indicated in this figure. There we see how a bulk power system is composed. Look at the generation and the transmission sides of the system. The electrical generator is an electrical machine. It could be either a synchronous or an induction machine. The electrical machine voltage is initially stepped up with a transformer, where the voltage is raised and made suitable for transmission lines. The transmission lines would allow the electrical power to travel several hundreds of miles. The voltage level depends on the utility standards, and the goal is to decrease losses. Electrical power will eventually arrive at the distribution level. There, a substation will step down the voltage to be compatible with commercial, industrial, or residential customers. At the local distribution, there are residential customers with transformers stepping down to probably 120 volts or maybe 220 volts. The standards for voltage and frequency depends on how and where the power grid is located. For example, in the United States is 60 Hz, while in Europe it is 50 Hz. This centralized architecture allows unidirectional electrical power flow. It was developed 100 years ago. However, we are now in the 21st century. We need a better and more enhanced integrated analysis and simulation approach to implement a bi-directional and intelligent design of smart grids. We have to make possible greater and further integration of renewable energy sources. Modern and smart series require sustainability. We have to make our current and future generations to live in a circular economy where sustainable and smart electric power grid is our reality of this 21st century.
We can understand that the power system and electricity needs were much simpler. The electrical grid was designed to deliver unidirectional electricity. Power systems engineers will define an equivalent load, most of the time linear, with a prescribed power factor. The Thevenin equivalent is then used for analysis. Simple control systems can be developed based on steady-state analysis. Power systems engineers will discuss frequency variation as related to electrical power flow and voltage variation as related to reactive power needs. Utilities and substations are assumed to operate under an aggregate loaded with a long time span, seconds and hours. Power electronics engineers will define an equivalent sinusoidal voltage source at the point of common coupling. They will study how their circuits affect the current taken from the utility. The control system's concerns for power electronics engineers are relevant only to the device designed by the engineer. Power electronics control are designed for the proper instantaneous operation, short time span, typically on the order of milliseconds and microseconds. The figure shows how it was the past power grid architecture, very centralized. One large power station would be connected to a substation. A system operator would manage the requirements and constraints. Typically, operations were done with telephone communications, some local adjustments and set points managed by operational engineers. The distribution would serve feeders for industrial, commercial, and residential customers. Not only the power flow is unidirectional in this architecture, there is absolutely no ramifications or mesh loops, nor any interaction, neither any interconnection of any kind of distributed generation. Such a power grid existed from their very beginning until 1960s and 1970s. The major concerns by that time were only losses and reactive power. Phasor analysis and steady-state considerations were sufficient for any design. Protection was very simple. Sinusoidal perfect ideal conditions were adequate for any technical considerations.
When a traditional electrical power grid is centralized on a large power plant, there are three loops of control that coordinate the system. The fuel at the boiler will have a set point defined by the operation, and the steam at a given pressure P will be maintained by the firing and burning of the provided fossil fuel. The steam will expand through a turbine, and the governor of such turbine will maintain an output torque at a given speed. The generator is connected on the turbine shaft. Therefore, for a prescribed speed, the field excitation of a synchronous machine will allow the generator to supply the required power with a reference voltage, defining the leading reactive power required for the operation. The same principles can be applied to hydropower plants. If an induction machine is used instead of a synchronous machine, D and Q transformation will allow the machine to match the operating torque and angular speed to supply power. But such a control system is dynamic and a little more complicated than in synchronous machines. Synchronous generators are usually the choice for multi-megawatt installations, while induction machines are used for kilowatts to around a few megawatts, mostly in distributed generation-based systems. The original centralized structure has been modified and improved since 1980s until recently. The power grid becomes further connected to renewable energy source and distribution control centers using SCADA, which consists of field data interface device, PLCs, sensing devices with local control switchboxes, and valve actuators. The communication systems could be a combination of radio, telephone, cable, and satellite. A supervisory control and data acquisition, SCADA, allows a utility operator to monitor and control process on various remote sites. We see in the figure the current grid architecture which is further evolving into more interaction and connectivity. There are some distributed generation aggregation with some bidirectional power flow, still built on the legacy of the existing power grid. The slide shows a voltage source converter with three possible inner controls based on ABC natural frame, alpha beta stationary frame, and DQ synchronous frame. The C-link voltage is controlled with a PI regulator. A phase lock loop will provide the instantaneous transformations with a current controller that will generate the modulating signals for a sinusoidal pulse width modulation scheme. The diagram is the state of the art today. Power electronics applications allow different inverter interfaces. Typically, PV photovoltaic systems require power converters to convert their DC output from the solar cells to AC alternating current. Fuel cells also output DC. Common electrical equipment and loads are AC. Wind energy systems may also have a double PWM back-to-back converter, where a DC link will allow a similar utility grid connection. Inverters can be designed to be voltage fed with transistors and diodes in anti-parallel for an input voltage link, or current fed with transistors and diodes in series, or for large power applications, thyristors, where the input is a current link. In early applications, grid-connected inverters were supposed to only supply active power and run at unit power factor. Initially, IEEE as well as IEC standards prohibited inverters to regulate the voltage at the point of common coupling, PCC, and they were mandated for protection disconnect as soon as possible on most of grid disturbance. With higher and further penetration of renewable energy source, the inverter controls became enhanced to provide advanced functions such as voltage and frequency write-through, voltage regulation, frequency response, and communications for monitoring and control. The current new generation of advanced inverters is defined as a smart inverter, also called as a multifunctional inverter. In addition of designing the internal inverter's algorithms based on classic, digital, or modern control, with the state of the art, it is also necessary bidirectional communications with the utility, user-friendly interface, net metering, some level of lead follower energy management control, leading to huge and big data amenable for computer science, machine learning, as well as artificial intelligence applications. Here we can see three statements about the smart grid being a two-way dialogue of electricity and information. We, as educators, engineers, researchers, and technology decision makers, we must be engaged and proactive in the social impact of a future grid. Our approach for a sustainable society must allow further penetration of renewables, user interaction, incorporation of plug-in electric cars. The future is what we do now. The smart grid is the new infrastructure of today's grid. Distributed generation, DG, has a power electronic interface capable of processing active power from the primary energy source, for example, solar, wind, a battery, or a fuel cell. The power grid is evolving by shifting energy supply from large central generation stations to smaller distributed energy resources, DERs. Therefore, power electronics technology is the enabler. The power electronics interface performs ancillary services such as grid support, low voltage write-through, harmonic compensation, constant power generation control, including online correction of undesired effects such as harmonic contents, presence of unwanted reactive and unbalanced power, sags, poor voltage regulation, detection of imminent fault conditions, islanding allowing intelligent fault recovery. Power electronics interface enable flexible, cost-effective, and energy-efficient solutions for hybrid AC-DC systems. Integration with machine learning and data science will incorporate advanced forecasting, cybersecurity technologies for a major role in a new resilient smart grid technology architecture. Multifunctional inverters become multitask inverters, devices applied to small-scale power generation and useful in enhancing power quality, system reliability, system resilience, and modern protection features. The modernization of the electric power grid requires an advanced network of communications, controls, computers, automation with new technologies and tools. We have to work towards a near future where active and intelligent utilization of all the different flexible energy resource potentials are available at all voltage levels, and make possible local and system-wide flexibility service with increased resilience. The current industrial reality, as well as our contemporary education of electrical engineers, still supports analysis of grid power system controllers designed for damping transient stability and power oscillation phenomena for radio-based protection needs. Nowadays, power electronics are still taught and researched with the traditional legacy on voltage frequency control mechanism, the droop control. New mechanisms for inverter-based controls have been developed and must be widely implemented and adopted by the industry. Our students and engineers must be trained for the 21st century workforce. In the future smart grid, the energy storage must be integrated with different energy networks and different vectors, making possible that our society will have an intelligent enhancement of our infrastructure of electricity, heat, gas, transport, hydrogen, water, and waste. Future smart and flexible energy systems require new protection and control solutions, as well as operation and planning principles based on optimal and coordinated utilization of flexible energy resource at all voltage levels. A teamwork of electrical engineers, electronic hardware and software designers, computer scientists, and even economic and social modeling professionals must have a vision for big data engineering in order to develop the future smart grid. We need parallel processing, parallel for splitting complex and computational problems into smaller ones to be solved by individual processors or by cores in a large computational power computer. Cloud computing for distributed and networking on demand, data storage, remote processing, and remote applications. Cybersecurity, as the electric grid evolves into a big data and multidimensional space, there is increased interdependence across power and cyber technologies. We have potential risks for cyber attacks. Therefore, it's very important that the future intelligent power grid has cybersecurity measures to identify and mitigate cyber threats. A lifetime online simulation based on digital twin technology is also a very important enhancement of the future smart grid.